Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Leeann, and in today's video, I'm going to share with you my thoughts on what a beginner makeup kit should have. I'm going to start off this video starting from the base makeup and ending with the lips. And I did an everyday makeup routine, which is exactly what I did today. I actually went out today, so I apologize if I'm like out of breath. I'm a little headachey, but I'm still in the mood to film this video. But I did an everyday makeup routine last year. I'll link it down in the description box below, so check it out. I'm gonna preface this video by telling you that I have not worn makeup since I think my second or third year of college, my undergraduate studies, and that was in 2011 or 12. Yeah, it's been 6 years since I last wore foundation, and I'll just tell you a little bit about that. When I first started wearing makeup in 2008 because of Michelle Phan and her amazing videos back then, I was using some drugstore ones. I used Revlon ones. I don't remember all of them, but I think I do remember using a Laura Geller one. It was a stick foundation, and I realized that even though it made my skin look really nice and even and, I don't know, very smooth looking, I guess, I still felt like there was something sitting on my face. It was so heavy, especially in the summers. It was the absolute worst. So I'm not going to sit here and tell you that you should not wear foundation if you're a beginner makeup user. This video is also not geared toward a certain age. If you're just starting makeup in your teens, or you're in college, or you're in your 30s or 40s, it doesn't really matter. It's just that for me, I don't recommend wearing foundation if you are not comfortable with the thought of having layers on your face. I realized that after I took off the foundation every night that my skin just felt, my skin was able to breathe, but I was breaking out so much, and it had a lot to do with the fact that I wasn't removing it properly, just because back then in the YouTube community for beauty, it was more focused on makeup than skincare. So, but I have a video on how to properly remove makeup, so do give that a watch if you're just starting out in makeup. I wasn't removing it properly and I was just breaking out too much, and as soon as I stopped wearing foundation and I just solely used concealer and powder, my skin was, I would have to say, was perfect. Perfect. I was no longer breaking out. Any breakouts that I had, it was just like hormonal stress, but it was not attributed to wearing foundation, which I was so thankful for. So in this video, I won't talk about any foundations just because I haven't worn that in a long time. Anyways, let's get into the video. So I still use a primer even though I don't use a foundation, and this is the Cover Effects Calming Primer. I'm actually almost done with this primer, and I've had this for like 3 or 4 years now, and it's lasted me this long just because I don't wear foundation, so I'm not putting primer all over my face. I'm only spot treating whatever I need, so that's gonna be my eye area and any acne spots. I don't even cover the darkness or redness around my nose or my corners of the mouth. I just don't do that anymore. I don't need that. So I definitely recommend, though, if you do have oily or combination skin, to invest, or not even invest, but to get a foundation primer, just so that your makeup will stick to your face better. And I find that whenever I did not wear a foundation primer underneath my concealer, it just had a tendency to fade, and it just didn't make any sense for me to put any makeup on if it wasn't sticking to my skin. I definitely recommend that you pick up a primer. I also want to mention that there's a mix of drugstore and high-end in this video. It's just because when I first started out in makeup, I was buying stuff from the drugstores like Duane Reade, but I eventually moved up to MAC and then I found Sephora. I think that if you are on a budget, the drugstore just has great things, but my point in making this video is to just tell you how to build your kit and what you should have in there. So I'm not really talking about the products. I really love this primer though, because it's a calming primer. It has ingredients in there to calm down any irritation and redness that you have in your skin. And for me, I have that from eczema patches and active pimples and pimples that I just popped. So that really helps. But if you have dry skin, I think you could get away with not using a primer at all because you don't have the oils in your skin to break down your makeup during the day, and the added layer you might not feel comfortable with. But for those with oily or combination skin, I definitely recommend it. The next thing is a concealer. I actually use two concealers in my routine, and I've been doing that for the past couple years only because my mom wanted to try the It Cosmetics one, and I do like it, so I use it for my under eyes only. But for years and years and years and years, I was only using this concealer, and this is the Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Eraser Dark Circle Treatment Concealer, and this is the shade medium. And I really like this because it works for spots and under eyes. The only reason I didn't go back to just using this, not because I got that concealer, the It Cosmetics one, I want to use it, but because I found this to be a little bit drying, and I'm 27, so my under eyes are going to be a lot drier than probably most teenagers. So I would just say, if you're a beginner though, you could possibly use two concealers, one specifically for the under eyes. Even though this is the treatment dark circles for your under eyes, I find that it's just too dry for my under eyes now. So you could use another concealer that's specifically made for your under eyes or not. It's totally up to you. You have to really play around with makeup, but I say a concealer is definitely great for concealing your under eye circles if you have any, even if you have any under eye bags and any spots that you have on your skin. And I say don't buy one that's like skin tone and then a lighter skin tone color. Like, you don't need all of that for an everyday look. So just get it in the shade that matches your skin tone. The next product is a powder. I don't really pay attention to setting powders or finishing powders. I don't mind adding a little bit of color to my skin. I don't even mind using translucent powders that are the white ones that just set your makeup. It doesn't really matter to me. This is the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Powder for normal to oily skin, and this is in natural beige. Honestly, I think that most of the powders would match my skin tone, but I just get any skin tone powder, and this just sets all the areas on which I put my concealer. I'd say if you have really dry skin, you don't need a powder because it could technically make your skin even drier and cakier, but definitely for combo oily skin types, you should have a powder just to set those wet products so that they don't move on your face at all throughout the day. I think even for dry skin though, it might even be better for you to use a powder though, because you could technically experience that as well. The next product is a blush. I thought about if I should include a bronzer or a blush, but the thing is, I always go for a blush. I know there are some YouTubers out there, very few though, who say that they wear bronzers more than blushes, but for me, I always wear blush. I do not wear bronzers all the time. So this is the NARS Blush in Deep Throat. This is the shimmery version of Orgasm. Orgasm is more on the glittery side, so I decided to go for this one just because I wanted to try another shade, and it's beautiful. I'm wearing it today. Basically, like all the products I'm going to talk about today, I used on my face. You have to pick a color that matches your skin tone. I feel like peachy pinks look great on everybody's skin tone. If you have darker skin, you might want to go for like a more berry color. And if you have a lighter skin tone, you might want to go for like a baby pink. For me, I have medium skin tone, and I think peachy pinks look perfect. Peach blushes also look beautiful. And I love that it has a little bit of shimmer in it too, so that if you are not really comfortable with wearing a highlighter, you can just get a shimmery blush and it'll act as your blush and your highlighter. Next is my bronzer. Yeah, I thought about it, if you actually need a bronzer in your beginner makeup kit. But the thing is, a bronzer can be so versatile. So this is my Hoola bronzer by Benefit. And this is a beautiful bronzer because it doesn't pull off orange or brown. It just pulls off the perfect like tan look. Like, you know, you got a little bit of a tan. It's just really, really nice. It's very easy to blend as well, which is what you want in basically any powder product. But you can use this as a bronzer, so you can do the 3C shape. Is it 3C? No, 3E shape. And then you can put it in your crease as a crease shade. You can even put it all over your lids if you want to for a very nice wash a one color wash over the lids. You can even use it to contour your nose if you want to. So I did that today. Whenever I don't want to go too crazy with like a cream contour, I just use my bronzer, and it's perfect for that. You just put it right down the bridge of your nose. I'm not bridge of your nose, the sides of the bridge of your nose, and it just slims down the nose a little bit, and also adds a little bit of like a sun-kissed look to your face. I mentioned that you don't need a highlighter if you don't feel comfortable with it, because a highlighter can take you from looking like you just always wake up with dewy skin, but it can also take you to like, are you going to a party or are you the party? Are you going to a disco or are you the disco ball? This is one of my favorite highlighters. This is by Chillwave, and this is in topaz, and I love Chillwave highlighters in general, but this is a beautiful color if you have a lighter skin tone. So topaz is your typical champagne color, really beautiful. But if you have, I would say, medium to darker skin tones, a gold looks really nice. And this is my Laura Geller Baked Gelato Swirl Illuminator in Gilded Honey. This is a cult favorite. I wore it on my face today, so I have it along my cheekbones, on the tops of my brows, underneath my brows, a little bit on my inner corners, totally faded, and down the bridge of my nose. I also added a little bit on my Cupid's bow to have a little bit of a pouty look. It just complements my skin tone. It looks super natural, and every time you turn your face, you can see there's a really nice dew there. Chillwave's highlighter does the same thing. I would say it's a little more on the like highlighty side than this one, but both of them are beautiful. And you can also use these, you can use your bronzer, blush, and highlighter as your eye look. I did a look on that. I'll link it down below. I'll link everything down below. But you can definitely use these as your eye makeup as well, just to have a really seamless look on your face. And it looks so natural and really, really pretty. The only reason I would say you don't really need a highlighter is just because maybe your blush has shimmer in it, and highlighters from day to day can just look a little bit too much. But it's entirely up to you. For eyes, I definitely recommend a primer, and this is the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion. This is the original one. I love this primer potion. This is my most favorite eyeshadow primer that I've ever used, and I pretty much only have used this one and the NARS one. I did not like the NARS one at all. Everything that I put on top of it completely creased and melted off. So I definitely recommend that you try this one, or you just get a primer in general if you have very oily lids. So the reason you want a primer is because it helps to keep your eyeshadows, your eyeliner, even your mascara on your eyes all day without smudging or fading. And I even use it on my bare brows before I go in and fill my brows in, so that my brows stay in place all day. And the other thing is that it creates a tacky base for anything that you put on top of that to stick to, and it also makes the pigments of whatever eyeshadow that you use vibrant. It has a lot of uses, and I definitely recommend that you never skip out on a primer, even if you have dry skin. But for those who do have dry skin or dry lids, you can basically just go in with your concealer. Speaking of brows, before I really like get into eyes, is an eyebrow pencil. I know there are some people out there who believe that a powder looks more natural or is easier to work with. I disagree with that, just because I don't have that many brow hairs to work with, especially on my tails. So I find that a pencil looks more natural and is easier to control. Whereas if you go in with a powder, this is just adding another product to your kit, but you have to dip it in and really just like draw in strokes, and it's not going to look as natural for me as like when you use a pencil and you're able to just make little flicks wherever you need to, and to fill in any sparse areas. With a powder, you just end up filling in your entire brow and it looks really, really harsh. I have a lot of videos on my channel where I wear this, so you can just check those videos out. But for the most part, even for me, like, I love using brow pencils every day, and this is my favorite one. This is the NYX Professional Makeup Micro Brow Pencil, and this is in black, and it's my perfect shade. And it also comes with a spoolie on the end, which you definitely want to help blend out your eyebrow products. I even use this when I go in with a powder, since the powder obviously doesn't come with a spoolie. But this is the Anastasia Brow Powder Duo in Granite, and I only use the lighter shade here. The darker one is just way too dark. And this is my favorite eyebrow powder brush to use, and this is the MAC 266 brush. And it's just a very, like, it's a dense angle brush, and it deposits the perfect amount of powder. If you could see that, it just fits, so I can just drag it over here. And it creates a the perfect tail for me as well with this little angle here. But that's what I mean, like, you have to get these two instead of just getting this one thing. I definitely recommend that you get a pencil because it just looks way more natural and you have more control when you use it. If you have bold brows already, very full, I would say go for a brow gel. And this is the Essence Make Me Brow Eyebrow Gel Mascara. Unfortunately, they only come in two colors, and this one is the darkest one in 02 Brownie Brows, and I really like this. I don't really use it that much anymore just because I feel like every time I prime my brows with the primer potion, it pretty much like stays in place. I mean, it rained today too, but this one is really good. It deposits a little bit of color, so if you need a little bit of shading for some sparse areas for your really bold, beautiful brows, go for a gel mascara that has color in it. And it keeps your brow hairs like very tame, very groomed, and it also adds a little bit of fullness if you need that. Back into the eyes, I'm just going to say, if you want to have some eyeshadows in your kit, I recommend instead of buying like those single shadows, because you're kind of limited because you only have a single shadow, I would say go for a palette. And I don't have a lot of drugstore palettes just because I just spend too much time at Sephora, but I recently in February got the Carly Bible Deluxe Edition 12 color eyeshadow and highlighter palette, and it's gorgeous. I featured this in too many videos of mine. And it just has neutral colors, and it also gets a little bit dark here, so you can definitely use some of the dark colors to line your eyes if you don't want to use an eyeliner. And it also comes with beautiful highlighters on the bottom, so it kind of has like your all-in-one palette. It obviously doesn't have a blush and a bronzer. It's gorgeous. It's pigmented. It's very easy to blend. I feel like this is one of the most beginner friendly palettes that I've ever come across. The next products are eyeliners. I like to use eyeliners because I feel like when I define my eyes with a liner, my eyes look much bigger and they look more defined. And because I have like a bigger nose, I feel like when I don't wear eyeliner and I just use mascara, my nose, it just looks big, you know what I'm saying? And my favorite eyeliner color is purple. And I know that sounds kind of crazy to have in your beginner makeup kit, but I feel like if you want to get a little bold with color but you don't want to use eyeshadow, go for a colored eyeliner. Purple for me works the best because I've used other colors like green and blue, and they've always just smudged really badly. I don't know what it is about the pigments, but purple never does that to me. And this is the Essence Long Lasting Eye Pencil in Purple Rain. I don't think they sell this anymore. I got this when I was in Germany, and I checked on Ulta's site here back at home, but they don't have this anymore. But so many brands make beautiful purple eyeliners. One of my favorites has to be the Maybelline one, which I can't find because it's like this tiny little nub now, and I'll link it down below, but that's one of my favorites. These are all drugstore products. If you want to go just natural for every day, for school, church, or just every day, you want to be natural, brown is your best friend. Brown for me is like, it's not a boring color, it just defines the eyes but does it in a really natural way. And this is the CoverGirl Liqueline Blast, I think, eyeliner in brown. And this is my favorite brown eyeliner, as you can see. I think I've gone through like 3 or 4, and if you can tell, I only use pencils because I find that, oh gosh, using those gel pot eyeliners and having to dip your brush in there and doing it, like, everything I feel like is so unforgiving, especially liquid eyeliners. For me, I just don't like those. So pencils are definitely easy because they don't dry down as fast as other aligners, and then you can just use a Q-tip and clean up whatever you need. So if you can see, I always wing out my eyeliner, and I'll get into the next product that you should have in your makeup kit to really get the perfect winged eyeliner, or just any liner that you want, and kind of like just get rid of any smudges. And if you even want to smudge out your liner, you can do that. This is my little medicine bottle that I upcycled, and I actually put in these precision Q-tips by the Q-tip brand, and it's basically a dual-ended Q-tip that has pointed ends. I'll do a video on how I do my winged eyeliner, but basically every time I draw a wing, it doesn't ever get this sharp. Sometimes it does, like when I, like on a really good day, like this one was giving me a little bit of problems. So I just use one end and I kind of just like, that's it. I don't need to use a brush and concealer. I don't need to use powder. I just wipe it away and bada bing, bada boom, I got my perfect wing. The next product is an eyelash curler, and this is my trusty Shiseido eyelash curler. You can definitely get eyelash curlers at the drugstore if you want to, but Shiseido has been my favorite. This is my second one ever. I've only had 3 eyelash curlers in my lifetime. My very first one was Revlon, and that pinched my eyes until I decided to get a Shiseido one, and then I had to throw that out because I was using that for like 7 years or something, and now this is my third one. But the reason I love the Shiseido one is because I didn't understand curlers. So you have to get one that matches your eye shape. Asians have flatter eyes, so it's best to not have that much of a curve on the curler. But if you have not flat eyes, you want one that's more curved. So that's why I like the Asian eyelash curlers way better than the one for non-Asians. Mascara is a little tricky. Actually, mascara is very tricky. One mascara that works for somebody might be completely disastrous for somebody else. I don't really watch videos about mascaras just because that's one of the most personal products that you'll ever use. I have 3 here. I love the L'Oreal False Lash. This is like the butterfly effect mascara. But basically, I love to have 2 mascaras. I know it sounds crazy, but I love 2. This one is my everyday lengthening and defining mascara. Doesn't give much volume, which is totally fine because I don't want to have like boom in your face like all day from day to day. I don't need that. But if I want to, oh, by the way, I have the L'Oreal mascara on today, which I don't think you can see because I'm pretty far away, but that's what I have on my lashes today. But if I do want that volume, that thickness, a little bit of length, you know, but really like boom in your face, Essence Lash Princess False Lash Effect Mascara, one of the best mascaras there is out there. So beautiful. It does exactly what I just mentioned that it does, that I want in a mascara when I like go out at night, when I go out on a date, when I just want to look a little extra. I've worn this to I only got this like last year or this year or something, so I can't say if I wore it to work, but I would definitely wear it to work. CoverGirl's Lash Blast Volume Waterproof Mascara, very similar, but this is a little bit more like on the clumpy side, but not clumpy so much that it looks like disgusting like spider legs. But this was my favorite mascara for so long until I decided to stop using waterproof mascaras. My other favorite mascara, which I forgot to bring with me, it's over there, but it's the L'Oreal Double Extend Beauty Tubes Mascara. It is an amazing everyday mascara. It's not waterproof, but it stays on your lashes all day because it's a fiber mascara. It only comes off with warm water. It's kind of crazy, but you don't need to use a makeup remover to remove that. It has a primer on one side and it has the mascara color or mascara on the other end. And so you apply the primer first and then layer it with the mascara, and it stays on your lashes all day. The thing that I will say about it is that it doesn't hold a curl, so your lashes will be like this when you curl them and then start to fall like pretty much within 10 minutes I think of application. But for every day, love that mascara a lot. I forgot to mention something for the face, and you should definitely have this. It's a spray, a setting spray, a finishing spray, whatever you want to call it. This is my DIY spray that I use in my skincare routine, and I use it to set my makeup. And I will leave the link to the blog post that I posted about this with the ingredients and the measurements and everything like that. So I will leave that down below for you to check out, but definitely have a spray in your arsenal because it sets your makeup really well so that it stays on all day, and it also gets rid of that cakey powdery look when you set your makeup with a powder. And the last makeup-y part is the lip products. I don't want to get too crazy. If you're just a beginner and I don't know, you want to do just every day and you want the natural look, I would say go with a tinted balm. And my choice has to be the Dior Lip Glow Color Reviver Balm. And yes, it's Dior, it's super luxurious and whatever, But the thing about this is that it gives you a beautiful pink color to your lips and it looks really natural. It's also moisturizing, but if you're looking for a little bit of color, now I do not really say get a lip liner and a lip product and everything. It's just a little bit too much. But let's just say you do want a long-lasting lip product, go for a liner. All you have to do is just get one liner. So this is the Rimmel Exaggerate Full Color Lip Liner in 103 Pink a Punch. I don't even know if they make these anymore. I mean, I have the same one in East End Snob. For all you OG beauty YouTubers or viewers, you'll know why these liners are amazing. East End Snob is going to be your everyday color. And if you want to just have a little bit of a punch, like I love bold lips. I don't really like nude lips, so I would always grab for something bold. You can go for this one. I have some other liners here. I have the NYX liner in, I think it's just called Pink. You can see it's on the bottom here. And then I have these nude ones. This one is Makeup Forever's Aqua Lip in 1C. This is Max Soar. And this is Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Lip Pencil in Naked 2. These are just going to be your nude colors. Soar is a little bit darker than a nude, but it adds a beautiful dark look. It's really nice. I would probably say that I prefer that to nude colors, but I still love my pink ones. If you're looking for not a lip liner but something that's long lasting, I would say to go for a liquid lipstick or go for something that you can make into a tint. So I basically think that you can make any lip product into a tint. So these are my favorite lip creams ever. These are the NYX Soft Matte Lip Creams. I have this one in Addis Ababa, my favorite one of all time. I have this on my lips right now. I have it in Stockholm and I have it in Antwerp. I have some other ones, but these are basically my favorite, my go-tos, especially for the spring. And the reason I love these is because they feel very comfortable on the lips. They can get a little bit drying, but you can just put a balm over the top and it's not going to get rid of the pigment. So I have Addis Ababa on my lips, and the reason it doesn't look the same is because I'm running out of this, and when it starts to run out, you're not going to get a lot of product out of the tube. So what you're going to get on your lips is this beautiful stain. It's just going to last all day, unless of course you eat, and it's very comfortable on the lips. You can even put your balm over the top to revive the moisture. It's so beautiful. And if you're looking for a gloss, the Fenty Beauty Gloss Balm is my favorite lip gloss of all time. Of all time. Because of its smell and because it gives a very like nice nude natural look, but the shine on this gloss is unreal. It's beautiful, it's juicy. By the way, if you haven't already thought about it, add a balm to your kit, please. You want to apply a balm at the very beginning of your makeup routine just so that the balm can work its magic and make your lips really soft for application afterward. Also, I just want to say before I continue, I think that in your makeup starter kit you should also have brushes, and I will do a separate video that's coming up after this video, so be sure to subscribe and check that video out. I will show you all the brushes that I have and love in my kit. Okay, so I forgot to mention another thing that you should have in your beginner makeup kit is the Sephora Mini Color Switch by Vera Mona. So basically what this is a sponge that you can use for switching your shadow colors on the same brush. So let's just say you use a pink eyeshadow and you apply it to your lids. If you want to use the same brush, yes, you can always like switch to the other side, but if you want to use the third color or even the second color, all you have to do is just swirl or like swipe your brush onto the sponge and it'll completely get rid of that color so that you can dip into your palette into another color and then apply it to your lid. So this is definitely something to get if you are thinking of using eyeshadows and you only have a couple brushes in your kit already. The last thing that I think that you need in your beginner starter kit is a pack of alcohol pads. So the reason I love alcohol pads is because I just use these after every day I come home and I sanitize my makeup. So I always wipe down my curler and I just wipe my liner, like the tip off, and I even use the rest of the solution on my phone and everything else that I need to sanitize for that day. But they look like this, and you rip them open and the cloth looks like this, and it's super, super saturated. So if you don't want to get alcohol pads, you can always just get rubbing alcohol, like in the big bottle, and just put a little bit of alcohol on a paper towel or even a cotton ball and sanitize your makeup like that. But you want to do that all the time, because you'll just have a lot of eyeliner, just basically a lot of makeup on your tools, and you just don't want to use that all the time, and you don't want to spread bacteria as well. So definitely get yourself some alcohol pads. So that was my thoughts on what you should have in your starter makeup kit. Let me know in the comments what you have in your starter kit, or what you think beginner makeup users should have in their kit. Give this a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe to see more videos from me, and click that notification bell to get notified of all future uploads. Thank you so much for watching. I'll leave all my social media platforms down below in the description box, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.